Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released macOS 12.2.1 to the public. This is available to all macOS 12 supported devices or macOS Monterey, so if you have that version installed, you should see this update. And it's available at the same time everywhere around the world, so if you're not seeing it, you can just go to your system preferences, go to software updates, and you can find the update there. So you can see it's 12.2.1, and this came in at 1.04 gigabytes. That's on my 16 inch MacBook Pro with the M1 Max processor. Now, again, this came out alongside other updates as well, such as iOS and iPadOS 15.3.1, as well as watchOS 8.4.2. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to the Apple, click on About This Mac, and as you can see, it says version 12.2.1. If we click on that, you'll see the build number here. And I go over the build number just so that you understand that you're on the latest version if you have the matching build number. So that lets you know which version you're actually on, where it says 21D62. So that's the current version with this particular update. So in this update, they fixed a major bug that quite a few people were having and quite a few messaged me about, and that has to do with battery. So this update fixes the issue many had with battery draining when the Mac is sleeping and not plugged in at night. So if you had it sleeping and then also connected to Bluetooth accessories, when you put it to sleep, it actually would cause problems where it would drain the battery. So maybe you have Bluetooth accessories like me here. You'll see it could be a trackpad, it could be a magic keyboard or anything else that would cause that excessive battery drain and cause you to maybe wake up when you're ready to go and not have any battery life. Now, if you're leaving it plugged in like I am with an external monitor, then you wouldn't notice this problem. However, it's only on Intel Macs that have this problem. So if you've noticed it on an M1, it doesn't seem to resolve it. However, I haven't had that issue on the M1s. It seems to be just related to Intel. Now, other than that, they haven't mentioned any other fixes in this particular update. So they're probably leaving most of those for macOS 12.3 that's currently in beta. However, they did address some security updates as well. So if we go to Safari and we go to Apple's security website, in the security website, if you scroll down, you can see the current versions of updates. So we have a Safari update, macOS Monterey, watchOS, and iOS. Click on macOS Monterey, scroll down, and you can see what they've actually resolved. It has to do with WebKit, which affects Safari. So you'll see here, it says processing maliciously crafted web content may lead to arbitrary code execution. Apple is aware of a report that this issue may have been actively exploited. To fix it or the description, a use after free issue was addressed with improved memory management, and it was reported by an anonymous researcher. This is the exact same issue that they resolved in iOS 15.3.1, so they've patched it here as well. As far as any additional fixes or features or changes or anything else, they have not mentioned anything else in this update. So there could be additional security updates, but we're not aware of any specific updates within this update. Now, if you're wondering if you should install this update, well, if you were having that battery drain issue, then absolutely. Also, when it comes to security updates, I highly recommend you install this update. However, if you're a beta tester, you won't see this update, but you'll be able to use those new features such as universal control and more. So if you wanted to try those features out, you could, but the beta is still a bit buggy. I'd probably hold off if you were thinking of trying to install that. However, if you're wondering when the final release will come out or when the betas will be out, I would expect the beta as soon as next week with beta 3, maybe a beta 4 the following week, and then in the first week of March, maybe a release candidate, and then a final release sometime around the 8th when we expect a new Apple event. That's typically when we expect Apple to release different things, and we can expect that then. So we'll have universal control, some additional features as well, and it looks like iOS 15.4 and macOS 12.3 are really ramping up to have a lot of features, but we won't see a huge amount of features until WWDC in June. Usually within the first or second week of June, we'll have WWDC or the Worldwide Developer Conference, where we'll have iOS 16 and macOS 13. And we're not exactly sure of the actual name yet, but many have said that it might be called Mammoth. So we'll have to wait and see what they call that, but we'll expect that along with watchOS 9 and more. Hopefully a few surprises as well. Also in that beta is mention of Reality OS. So it looks like that's Apple's new VR or AR headset OS. So maybe we'll see that as soon as WWDC. But as far as this particular update, there's not a whole lot in it. So we're just waiting for those final versions where we can try out universal control that was promised last June. Now, as far as overall battery life should be about the same as it was before, where If you were not having that issue with the battery drain, it should be the same. If you were, well, this should be greatly improved. So definitely worth installing to fix that specific issue. And I typically leave this Mac plugged in, so you're not going to see a whole lot of battery. I wouldn't expect it to affect performance either. Basically expect performance to be exactly the same. No issues there. And so that's everything in macOS 12.2.1. Of course, I'm looking forward to that final version of 12.3, where we have additional features such as universal control, more control over our keychain with notes, and much, much more. I'm looking forward to that, and hopefully we find even additional features that we weren't expecting in the final release. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link one in the description below. It will be for the iPhone, so you can try that out yourself. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.